गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू पोल साइंस क्लास। एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस टू लास्ट टॉपिक ऑफ दिस चैप्टर एंड ऑफ बायोपोलैरिटी। फर्स्ट वन इज टेंशंस एंड कॉन्फ्लिक्ट्स एंड सेकंड वन इज इंडिया एंड पोस्ट कम्युनिस्ट कंट्रीज। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट आवर फर्स्ट टॉपिक, टेंशन एंड कॉन्फ्लिक्ट्स। Most of the former Soviet republics are prone to conflict. Prone means position, area to conflict, and many have had civil wars and insurgencies means revolt, and complicating the picture of the growing involvement of outside power. In Russia, two republics, Chechnya and Dagestan, have had violent secessionist movement, mean an act of accedit and joining. They start a movement, and Moscow's method of dealing with Chechnya rebels and indiscriminate means without any thought. Totally thoughtless military bombing have led to many human rights violation and failed to deter and stop the expectations for independence. Means people of this area wanted to get freedom, these two republics, but Moscow start a campaign to suppress their expectation of freedom. In Central Asia also, Tajikistan witnessed a civil war that went on for many years till 2001. The reason was, as a whole, has many sectarian conflicts. There were many conflicts in Azerbaijan province of Nagorno and Karabakh. Some local Armenians want to leave it and join Armenia. In Georgia also, the demand for independence has come from two provinces. Means it was the time of conflicts. Means this era was a symbol of the absence of peace. Everybody was involved. Every country was involved in conflicts. So there are movements against the existing regime in form of government in Ukraine, Kyrgyzstan, Georgia. Countries and provinces are fighting over river water. All this has led to instability, making life difficult for ordinary citizen. It's very easy to say, because if there will be conflict in any area, then it will make the life of a common person very difficult, because a simple person has to face many problems. And the Central Asia republics are arena with vast hydrocarbon resources, means petroleum, gas, etc., natural resources, and which have brought them economically benefit. So that's why other country also wanted to capture it. And Central Asia has also become a zone of competition between outside powers and oil companies. Just because of the resources, the Central Asia has become a zone of competition where many outside powers came there, and it was a matter of conflict between both. So the reason is next to Russia and China, Afghanistan and Pakistan. Close to West Asia, after 11 September 2001, it was an incident of attack on America. The US wanted to military bases in the region's area and he paid the governments of all the Central Asian state to hire bases and to allow his aeroplanes to fly over their territories during the war in Afghanistan and Iraq. However, Russia also considered these states as its near abroad because it was fruitful for Russia, beneficial for Russia, and believes that they should be under Russian influence, and China has interest here because of the oil resources, and that's why Chinese have begun to settle around the borders and conduct trade system to take the advantage of this situation and take the advantage and show their right on this area. In Eastern Europe, Czechoslovakia split peacefully into two, divided into two pieces, first Czecho and second Slovakias, so forming independent countries. But the most severe conflict took place in Balkan republics of Yugoslavia. After 1991, it broke apart with several provinces like Croatia, Slovenia, Bosnia, Herzegovina declaring independence. And the last, Serbs opposed this. So Serbia is and a massacre is when number of people were killed without rhyme and reason. It is called massacre of non-Serb Bosnia has followed the NATO intervention, and the bombing of Yugoslavia followed the inter-ethnic civil war. So this time was totally conflict and tension, and everybody was involved, everybody was fighting with others on different issues. One country is fighting for independence, second is fighting for resources, third one is fighting for water. Means every country was directly or indirectly entangled with each other. Now come to second point, India and post-communist countries. India has maintained good relationship with all the post-communist countries, but the strongest relation are still those between Russia and India. The relationship of India and Russia has a great history. India's relation with Russia are an important aspect of Indian foreign policy because Russia always supported India in every difficult situation. Indo-Russian relationship are embedded in a history of trust and common interest, and are matched by popular perceptions, thoughts. Both countries' relation has a good history. Even Indian heroes from Raj Kapoor, Amitabh Bachchan are household named in Russia and many post-Soviet countries. Means still now, Indian heroes and things are still famous in Russia. Means both have, it is the sign of good relation. And one can hear Hindi film song all over the region, and India is a part of popular memory. It is a part. And Russia and India share a vision, dream of multipolar world order. Multipolar means when many powers will emerge as a player on the ground of international politics. What they mean by multipolar world? Order is to coexistence on several powers in the international system. Collective security must be the motto of this, in which an attack on any country is regarded as a threat to all countries and required collective response means peace and greater realism, negotiated settlement in international conflicts, means try to avoid the war to a great extent and try to settlement the issues, and an independent foreign policy for all countries. Every country has choice to prepare to frame its own policy, foreign policy, and decision making through bodies like the UN that should be strengthened, means the decision taken by UNO must be considered the last decision related to any conflict and tension situation, and democratized and empowered. More than 80 bilateral agreements have been signed between India and Russia as part of the Indo-Russian Strategic Agreement of 2001. I mean, more than 80 agreements have been done between India and Russia. And India stands to benefit from its relationship. India is taking advantage from its relationship with Russia on issues like Kashmir, energy supply, sharing information on international terrorism. Because whenever there is an issue related to Kashmir, then USA always take the side of Pakistan and USSR, and means Russia always take the side of India. So, and information on international and access to Central Asia and balancing its relation with China. So Russia stands to benefit from its relationship because India is the second largest arms market for Russia. Russia is also taking advantage of this relation because India has great market for weapons. So India is a great consumer of weapons, so Russia is exporting his weapons to India. So Indian military gets most of its hardware from Russia, and since India is an oil importing nation and Russia is important to India, so that's why Russia is also important for India and has repeatedly come to the assistance of India during its oil crisis. Whenever India faces any kind of oil crisis, gas crisis, then Russia is always ready to help India. So that's why India is seeking to increase its energy imports from Russia and the republics of Kazakhstan and Turkmenistan. He is also trying to maintain his relation like Russia with his republic, Russia's republic, Kazakhstan and Turkmenistan. And cooperation with these republics included partnership and investment in oil field. Russia is important for India's nuclear energy plans and assisted India to space industry by giving, because Russia always help to settle satellite with the help of rocket of India. Russia is always supportive policy with India, and Russia also help India to create, to make its own nuclear weapons, and both prepare its BrahMos missile on the same time. So Russia and India have collaborate on various scientific projects. Now come to the last point, flashback India's and the USSR. During the Cold War era, India and USSR enjoyed a special relationship which had critics to say that India was part of Soviet camp and it was a multi-dimensional relationship. First, if we talk about first relation like economically, the Soviet Union assisted India's public sector companies at the time when such assistance was difficult to get. means USSR or Russia always help India in this critical time when no other country was ready to help India. Like it gave aid means instruments and technical assistance help for steel plant like Bhilai, Bokaro, Vishakhapatnam and machinery plants like Bharat Heavy Electricals Limited. And the Soviet Union accepted Indian's currency for trade when India was short of foreign exchange. Political, the Soviet Union supported India's position on the Kashmir issue in UN. It also supported India during its major conflicts, especially during the war with Pakistan 1971. During this war, America didn't help India. America was in favor of Pakistan. Then Soviet Union was in favor of India. So India too supported Soviet foreign policy in some crucial but indirect way. Military, third point, military from military way. India's received most of its military hardware from the Soviet Union at a time when few other countries were willing to part with military technologies. And Soviet Union entered into various agreements allowing India to jointly produce military equipment, like Brahmos is the example of it. And culture, both have almost same cultures, like Indian films and Indian cultures were popular in the Soviet Union, and a large number of Indian writers and artists visited the USSR. So both have good relation. So in this last two topics, we shall discuss about the environment of conflicts and tension, and second, relationship of India with Russia. So you are requested to listen it twice and thrice to understand this topic very clearly. Thanks and have a nice day.